the LEAD Goleta Academy.
The City of Goleta is pleased to announce the completion of the LEAD Goleta Academy. This was our fourth LEAD Goleta and the second bilingual one. LEAD Goleta stands for Learn, Empower, Advocate, and Discuss. And that's exactly what these 31 participants did for the past 6 weeks. They walked through the door every week, eager to learn. They were really engaged and they sincerely were here because they love Goleta and they wanted to learn.
I think it's really helpful to understand what goes on behind the scenes. We all live in a city, but we don't all know what's happening or how to get involved. And I think that's a huge barrier in like what we need versus what we want to see happen. So it's been really cool to learn how to do that.
It was really fascinating to learn how all the bits and pieces go together, the finance and the public works department. There's a lot more that goes into running a city than I think people realize. And so that's absolutely the thing I'll take away from it, is learning all about how that works.
We covered so much during the course of 6 weeks, it's mind-blowing. We had presentations from our city manager. He was able to kind of outline his role at the city and how the city functions in terms of having a council.
It's great to see a group of people that are so interested in learning more about what happens on a day-to-day basis in their city.
And then they also heard from each council member and the mayor. So they really got to see how each one is different and how all of those different personalities coming together is really representing the city in a great way.
I don't think they're going to forget that.
Next, they heard from the city's attorney's office and all the complexities involved with representing a city legally. They heard from the city clerk's office, which is really the glue that holds the city together. They heard from planning and the housing element, which is a hot topic in Goleta right now. They also heard from sustainability and environmental services.
We often think like these environmental problems are global, they're, you know, way above our heads, but actually it's happening right here, right down the street, where you can get involved and make a change.
What the public does can really help us.
They also heard from emergency services. They really enjoyed hearing from Goleta Police, and they got to meet the newest canine handler and canine.
Right now we have 4 canines, and he's the rookie.
Gosh, we learned a lot. We learned about the police department and the library. It just made it so worth it. I think that was our best class.
Another special moment, it was a tour that they got to take of the Goleta Valley Library. Some people are very familiar with the Goleta Valley Library, and for others, they were really there for the first time, getting to see all that the library offers. Another tour they took was of the Goleta Community Center, which has been closed due to seismic renovations. Another popular class was the Public Works presentation, where they got to hear about all the projects coming up, including Project Connect, which is the largest capital improvement project in the history of the city. They also heard from Parks and Recreation about all the exciting plans that are coming up at our parks.
Probably my favorite class would be when we learned about Parks and Rec and Joanne Plummer. She was full of life and full of energy. She really kind of got across to us what it meant to work for Goleta and how much she cared about what went into the Parks and Rec department.
So we are a small but mighty team, and we're excited every day to be here.
Another great presentation was from our Parks and Open Space Manager, George Thompson, who talked about one of Goleta's favorite topics, which is Elwood Mesa and the Monarch Butterfly Grove. He was able to answer a lot of questions and talk about the exciting future ahead. Community Outreach also gave a presentation on just how we interact with the media, with the community, about how we keep the public informed through all the various platforms. We had presentations from finance, neighborhood services, homelessness, and more.
On the January 18th, 2024, City Council will now come to order.
The proposal will create a 10 p.m. curfew for residents under the age of 18.
One of the most exciting moments at LEAD Goleta was the mock city council meeting What's great about it is we draw names out of the hat, from mayor to the council members to the city manager, city clerk, city attorney.
The mock city council meeting was really helpful because I've never been to a meeting of that scale, so I think it made it more approachable for me and just to kind of see how it worked.
10 o'clock, it's plenty late. I go to bed at 8:30.
And we even have participants who speak for and against a controversial ordinance.
I was a public speaker, so I got to come up with my own case and then present that to the council, and it was really fun.
Are you trying to ruin our life? most of the fun stuff happens after 10.
There's always a lot of laughs. There's definitely great learning involved in this exercise.
Hitting the gavel was great. That's probably my favorite part of the entire class.
For the first time at LEAD Goleta, we did a Goleta trivia test to test their knowledge.
Does anybody know what year was the city of Goleta incorporated? Raise your hand if you know the answer.
That was a fun experience to not only just be blasting them with information for the past 6 weeks, but to actually see what they retained.
2002, yes.
Yay, all right.
And make it a fun trivia game where we handed out prizes. This was a very diverse group that came from all walks of life. We had retirees, we had college students, high school students, business professionals. The list goes on and on. We are especially proud at LEAD Goleta that we are able to offer a bilingual experience. So we had 6 Spanish speakers in this class. That means that all of the content was translated.
Pues aprendí bastante de cosas de la comunidad que no sabía. Con esta sabiduría que pues salir más a conocer la ciudad y pues alentar a mis hijos a que estudien para su futuro una carrera.
It's important if you're offering a bilingual academy that you truly, authentically make it where the participants can participate in every aspect of the class. Everything that you're doing is translated into Spanish and vice versa. It was also translated into English for those who could not understand the Spanish.
It's the first time I've been involved in something that's so strongly bilingual, and I really appreciated that, having to hear the English. You know, I've never experienced that before, and I think that's really important for a city to be inclusive like that.
What's really great about LEAD Goleta is just that they get this behind-the-scenes look at how local government operates. And what they do with that information, we don't know. Hopefully they'll tell their friends, their neighbors, their family. Maybe they'll come back and join a board or commission. Maybe they'll run for city council. Whatever they do, we just hope that really they become ambassadors in a way where they have this inside knowledge and that they can use that knowledge to make their community a better place and hopefully serve in the future in some aspect.
I love that you got to see what I see every day, which is the passion and dedication of the staff. That is, to me, so special about Goleta, that we are all so invested in the future and the prosperity of this community, and you're part of that.
Of course, the grand finale was graduation night, and this was incredibly special because it was the first time we've had graduation at the Goleta Community Center. The mayor and council passed out certificates, and they also took photos. This was the first time we had friends and family of the participants able to come be a part of it as well.
I would recommend LEAD Goleta to every single high school student, and I think it just really made me a lot more educated than I was 6 weeks ago.
I actually learned much more than I thought. It really made me feel empowered to get more involved and that we can actually make meaningful change in our community.
I can't express enough how much this class was just eager to learn. We will never forget them. Hopefully they will all stay involved. We'll definitely miss seeing their faces every week, and we hope that they stay engaged because each of them bring a lot to the city. They were outstanding.